Hey there, Benjamin from LoveStarter here, welcome back. Today we're going to take a look at an update Google has made to the way you create and configure website conversions in Google Ads. I need to highlight that it seems like Google has been testing this updated conversion tracking setup for a few months, but I've only just started to see it pop up in some of my accounts. This means that you might see this update in your Google Ads account, or you might see the previous conversion tracking setup steps. Let's select Tools and Settings, and then Conversions to take a look. So far, nothing has changed, but let's select New Conversion Action, and then Website. Now, if you see this message that says scan your website for possible conversion actions to add, then it means you're using the updated conversion tracking setup. Before we take a look at the steps to scan your website, I also want to show you a technique I've found to get back to the previous conversion tracking setup steps. To get the old version back, take a look at the URL of the page. I've noticed that there is a parameter called ctinfo. And if you're looking at the updated steps, the value of this parameter is set to bulk underscore web page. But if we remove the first part of this, so if we remove bulk underscore, and then we load the page again, we can now see the previous conversion tracking setup steps. I need to flag that I don't know how long you'll be able to switch between the versions. Google could stop us from doing this at any time, but I just wanted to mention that it worked for me. Okay, now let's go back to the updated version. We can see that we can enter the domain for our website and that Google Ads will scan our website to see if we're using the global site tag or gtag.js. I generally recommend using Google Tag Manager and not the global site tag, simply because Google Tag Manager provides additional flexibility. For example, you can use it to manage your Google Ads tags, Google Analytics tags, and more. However, I'm going to show you how it works using the global site tag, and then I will show you how you can still use Google Tag Manager even if you're using this updated conversion tracking setup. So I'm going to enter my domain that uses the global site tag. And let's click Scan. We can now see we can add a page on our website as a conversion action. This lets us enter the URL of our confirmation or thank you page so that when people view that page, it will be counted as a conversion in Google Ads. To start, we can select a category for the conversion we are configuring. This is used to classify conversions in Google Ads. Let's select this option. We can see we can choose from a range of categories, including purchase, subscribe, contact, submit lead form, and so on. For this conversion, I'm going to select Submit Lead Form. We can then choose how to match the URLs on our website. Let's select this option. We can choose URL is, URL contains, or URL starts with. I'm going to select URL contains. And then I'm going to enter /thank-you. This will mean that when someone views a page on my website that contains /thank-you, a conversion will be reported in Google Ads. Now let's click Add. We can now see the conversion is listed. And let's click Settings. This lets us adjust the settings for the conversion. We can change the name, change the way values are assigned for the conversion, control how conversions are counted, and more. If you'd like to learn more about each of these options, then please take a moment to check out my Google Ads conversion tracking tutorial and my Google Ads course. I've included links in the description below this video. Now let's close this. The next option is to manually create conversions. Let's click Add a Conversion Action Manually to take a look. This is similar to the options we just saw when we selected Settings. Let's manually create a conversion to see how this works. Let's select Other for the category. And let's select Use the same value for each conversion and enter 10 as the value. Let's leave all of the other default settings for this conversion and click Done. We can now see our manual conversion is added to the list. Now let's click Save and Continue. Since we added a manual conversion, we can see we need to add an additional tag to our website to track the manual conversion. Selecting See Event Tag gives you the tag you need to add. And if you didn't create a manual conversion, then this page will show you the global site tag you need to add to your website if it's not already installed. Okay, let's click Done. You'll now see the new conversions you created on the conversion summary page. Finally, I want to show you how you can still use Google Tag Manager even if you use the updated conversion tracking setup. Let's click New Conversion Action one more time. And let's select Website. Let's enter our domain. And click Scan. If you want to use Google Tag Manager, then all you need to do is skip straight to the bottom and manually add a conversion. So let's click Add a Conversion Action Manually. We can then manually create a conversion like we did previously. Let's select Other for the category. Let's name the conversion GTM Example. Let's enter 10 as the dollar value for the conversion. Let's leave the other default settings. And click Done. Now let's click Save and Continue. There are no details here for configuring Google Tag Manager, so let's close this. Now we need to find our conversion. And click the name of our conversion. Now we can select Tag Setup. And we can choose the option to use Google Tag Manager. You now have the conversion ID and conversion label that you can use to configure the tag in Google Tag Manager. And to learn more about configuring conversions in Google Ads and Google Tag Manager, check out my Google Ads conversion tracking tutorial. I've included a link in the description below this video. Are you using the updated conversion tracking setup or the previous version? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.